everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Well, this tutorial is going to be amazing because in this tutorial I'm going to explain how you can easily create a dynamic column chart. By the way, I'm just using a word dynamic column chart. So what does it mean? It means that a chart which automatically fit according to the availability of the data. For instance, I have a data which varies with respect to the time. So what I want all the time when I just change the data or when I update it, so I want my chart should be automatically updated and should be adjusted according to the availability of the records. So what I will do, I'll just use the help of ChatGPT, where I'll ask ChatGPT to give me the formula for the offset, and offset I'm going to use in order to get the non-blank value in a column. So what I will do, I'll just simply ask ChatGPT, where I'll give the question that I'm just looking for the offset formula. And after getting the formula, what I'll what will be the next step? So first just parse me the query here. So well, don't need to scare because in the chart and I'm asking for the formula. So where I can use that formula, actually what I will do, I'll just take that formula into the name manager and I'll create a name manager here. So I will use that reference. Well, I have parsed my query here with the ChatGPT and I'm just waiting for the answer, and now the ChatGPT is giving the answer. Let's see. Okay, so this is the formula of the offset, and that formula will do what? It will take the complete range of a column, whereas I have mentioned the starting position of my first value in the column. And then what I will do, I'll just copy this formula and I will revert back to my Excel file. And here, you know, I'm just using the pivot table. And at this moment, I'm just using the category in the raw labels. Well, what I will do, I'll just move into the formulas and then I'll click the name manager and then I'll create a name manager here. So I just put the formula here and I'm just giving the name. It's up to you, whatever the name you want to give, you can give. It's up to you totally. So I'm just writing a series name, because what I'll do in the column A, that will be the series name, and same formula I'll copy and again we'll create a new name series that will be for the value of value that is given in basically, you know, in the second column. And I'll change it slightly. Either I can copy it from ChatGPT as well, because I have asked for the two formulas for column A and column B as well, but I can make amendment here. So these two name series have been created. What I'll do, simply I'll just create on the chart, and in the current scenario you can check it out. When I click over the chart, so it just show me the area only just available in the, you know, till raw number, till raw seven. Okay, first I will just off the grand total for the rows and column, because I don't want to see the grand total here. And now you can check it out, when I click over the chart, so it just representing me the area till raw 4 to raw 7. But as I told you earlier, that it is a dynamic chart. So what actually I'm just looking for, I just want it must be dynamic. So I just create a new chart here and I'm just using the series. So what I will do, I just press the F3. When you press the F3, then you will get the name of name managers as a reference. So what I'll click, I'll just use here the sheet name, sheet 1. I'll just clicking on the cell and removing the address and then the name of the name manager. It's okay. Now I will do what, I will take the another name manager that that I have just created recently, series name and series value. So I have taken both here. Now I just change it to the months. So in the first chart you can see that it is still till four records, but in the second one it is dynamic. So what I'll do, I'll simply just change the value as well in order to show you more that how is it working. So I'm just taking another field in order to make it more more extendable. Now you can check it out. In the first chart only you can still, you can only see there are the four columns, but in the second chart it is dynamic. So this is the reason, that's why I just called it a column chart with dynamic property. So in this manner you can make your dashboards or more interactive. And if you do this once, so you don't need to change it all the time, so you are not supposed to do it again and again. So this is a very good technique, and it's very helpful. So I hope you like this video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.